Alright, so when I press the key A, it plays and pauses the music. When I press the key B, it plays the next song in the playlist. And the key C plays the previous song. When I press the key 1, it increases my health to 100% in Vice City. And when I press the key 2, it adds a gun and an explosive grenade in my loadout in Counter-Strike. When I press the key 3, it opens Notepad on my PC. And the key 4 opens Chrome, and in that it opens Codometry.in. Similarly, we can also control OBS using this setup.
Hello everybody, Abhishek Ingurani here from Codometry. Today I'm going to show you how you can control your PC by sending it macro commands using an Arduino and make it do some complex tasks with just a click of a button. So let's get started. So you complete this project in just 3 simple steps. Now, if you wish to come back at any time or skip ahead on the timeline to any of these steps, you can find the times for each of these steps in the description. So let's start with the first step, Arduino sketch and hardware assembly.
Okay, so to trigger the commands, we'll use this keypad, and to send those commands to the PC, we'll use an Arduino board. I have kept the links for these exact components that I'm using in the description. So now let's attach these two together using jumper cables. In Arduino, I'll use the keys from D4 to D11 to attach the keypad.
Okay, now let's connect the Arduino to the PC. Now on the PC, let's first download the Arduino IDE.
Go to Arduino's website. Here, choose your preferred operating system and hit download. Windows users can also go to Windows Store, search for Arduino IDE and download and install it from there itself. Once the Arduino IDE is installed, go to Tools, Port, and make sure an appropriate port is selected. In my case, it's COM11. Now go to Tools, Board, and select the type of Arduino board that you have. In my case, it's Arduino Leonardo.
Oh, and I just want to point out that this project will only work with these Arduino boards.
Other Arduino boards such as Arduino Uno don't have the hardware necessary to interpret and send keyboard commands to the PC. So you can use any of these boards like Arduino Leonardo or Arduino Pro Micro, which is also from the Arduino Leonardo family. Moving on, let's go to Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries, and search for HID-project. And install this library from NicoHood. Next, we'll search for keypad, scroll down, and install the keypad library by Mark Stanley. Next, we'll go to my GitHub page of this project, the link for which is available in the description, and copy and paste the code from there to the Arduino IDE. Now, let's quickly go through this code and understand what's happening here. Firstly, we have imported both the HID project and the keypad library that we installed earlier. This section here is to set up our keypad. Here, we are saying that the keypad has 4 rows and 4 columns. And here, we just defined the layout of our keypad as it is. As the first row of our keypad has 1, 2, 3 and A, we have mentioned 1, 2, 3 and A in the first row of our code as well, and so on. Here, we are defining the digital pins of Arduino that we are using, which in my case is pin D4 to D11. Now, in the loop method, we are continuously reading the key that was pressed and storing it in the key variable. And in this switch case, we check which key was pressed and execute commands for that key. For now, we have just printed which key was pressed. So, if we press key 1, key 1 was pressed will be printed out on the screen. Okay, so let's upload this code and test it out. As you can see, our setup is working just fine.
First, let's program the key A to play and pause the music, the key B to play the next song in the playlist, and the key C to play the previous song.
Let's scroll down to case A. Now here we want to play and pause the music. For that, the HID project library that we installed earlier has provided a list of constants that we can use. So I'll open the link here, scroll down, and as you can see here, there is a list of key definitions such as to play and pause the music, to play the next or the previous song, and to increase and decrease the volume and so on. So let's copy the media play pause definition first. And in the code, we'll type in consumer.write and paste the key definition here. Now for the key B, we want to play the next song in the playlist. So we'll copy the same thing and just change the key definition to media next. Similarly, for the key C, we will copy and paste the code and change the key definition to media previous. So let's upload this code and test it out. Key A is playing and pausing the music, key B is playing the next song, and key C is playing the previous song.
Awesome, let's now move to some games.
Right, so let's program the key 1 to increase our health to 100% in GTA Vice City. Now, as you all probably know, the cheat code to increase the health to 100% in Vice City is aspirin. So here in case 1, we'll use the keyboard.print method and just print out aspirin one character at a time. You can also print the whole word together, but for me, one character at a time gives me better results. Moving on, let's program the key 2 to select a gun and a grenade in our loadout in Counter-Strike. Now in Counter-Strike, in the beginning of the game, while choosing loadout, you can press B to open the buy menu, then press 4 to select the rifles section, then press any number between 1 to 6 to choose a gun. I'll press 4. Now I'll press 6 to go to the grenade section and press 4 to select explosive grenade. So if I press B4464 quickly, I'll buy a gun as well as a grenade. So let's program this in case 2. Same as above, we'll print B4464 one character at a time.
Now when I press the key 1, it increases my health, and when I press the key 2, it adds a gun and an explosive grenade in my loadout in Counter-Strike. Now these were some simple use cases which only required us to press a few keyboard keys together. But what if I want to do something a bit more complicated, like open Skype, Chrome or Notepad or any other app in a similar way with just a click of a button?
With our current setup, we cannot do that directly. Because using our Arduino, we can just emulate a keyboard and send some keyboard keystrokes to our PC. We cannot send instructions like start an application to our PC using an Arduino. To achieve that, we'll use a program called AutoHotkeys. Now, AutoHotkeys lets us trigger a set of commands or actions if and when some keyboard shortcuts are pressed. For example, currently I have AutoHotkeys set up in such a way that when I press Windows plus Alt plus N, it opens Notepad. So you can see how we can use this to our advantage. Right, so let's download AutoHotkeys and install it. Just select Express Installation and continue. Now let's write a simple AutoHotkey script to open Notepad when I press Windows plus Alt plus N. Let's go to AutoHotkey's documentation to see how we can do that. Again, link for this is available in the description. Here, in the first example, the hotkey Windows plus N is configured to launch Notepad. And in the code, you can see that it will run Notepad when Windows plus N is pressed. Here, hash means the Windows key. Hash is a modifier for the Windows key. So if we scroll down, we'll be able to see a list of all the available modifiers. So hash stands for Windows, exclamation mark stands for Alt, and the plus sign stands for Shift, and so on. Now back to the example above, we'll copy this example and paste it in Notepad++, which is my text editor of choice.
Now, since we want to open Notepad when I press Windows plus Alt plus N instead of Windows plus N, I'll add an exclamation mark after hash and before N. Because as you can see in the documentation, exclamation stands for the Alt key. So now if I press Windows plus Alt plus N, it should open Notepad. So let's test it out. I'll save this file on the desktop with any name but with the extension .ahk. And now we'll run this file as admin. I'll press Windows plus Alt plus N, and as you can see the script is working just fine. Let's try one more thing. Let's open a website on Chrome with a shortcut. Let's say I want to open codometry.in when I press Windows plus Alt plus C. So to do that, let's open our script again. We'll copy and paste the code above and change the character N to C. We'll run chrome.exe and we'll provide the website that we want to run, which in my case is codometry.in. Let's save this, open the task tray, right click on the auto hotkey script icon and select reload the script. Now when I press Windows plus Alt plus C, it opens codometry.in in Chrome.
This was just a small set of features of auto hotkey. If you want a separate video for auto hotkey, then do let me know in the comments below. I'll try and create a separate detailed video for it. Moving on.
Right, so now from our keyboard, when we send a keyboard macro like Windows plus Alt plus N to our PC, it opens Notepad. But instead of our keyboard, we want to send the same command to our PC using our Arduino keypad. So when we press a key on our keypad like the key A is detected by Arduino. And in our Arduino script, when we detect the key A, we'll send the keystroke Windows plus Alt plus N to our PC, which will be interpreted by auto hotkeys and Notepad will be opened. So to do that, let's open our Arduino script again. Now when the key 3 is detected, we want to send the keys Windows plus Alt plus N. Now to get the syntax for that, let's open this link and refer the documentation of keyboard.h library. Here the key codes for all the keyboard keys such as Ctrl, Shift, Alt, etc. are already defined. So we can use these key definitions in our code. Here the key called keyleftGUI stands for the left Windows key. So we will copy this code, go back to our script and type in keyboard.press and paste the key definition here. Notice I'm writing press instead of write. Write is used when we want to press and release the key, and press is used when we want to press and hold the key. Similarly, we will duplicate this line, copy the key definition for Alt and paste it. And finally, we'll type keyboard.press N. Similarly, when the keypad key 4 is detected, we'll send Windows plus Alt plus C to open codometry.in in Chrome. In the end of the loop, we are releasing all the pressed keys. Let's upload this code to Arduino and test it out. And as you can see, when I press key 3, Notepad is opened. And when I press key 4, codometry.in is opened in Chrome.
Now for the people who use OBS to record our live stream, OBS also allows us to set hotkeys. So let's say you want to control features like start or stop streaming, change screens, etc. using our Arduino keypad, then you can assign hotkeys for them here and program the Arduino to send that hotkey like we did earlier. It is as simple as that.
Okay, now wouldn't it be cool if there was a physical knob using which you can increase or decrease the volume of your PC and also control apps like Lightroom and Photoshop and also control PowerPoint presentation and switch between browser tabs? This is exactly what we'll be doing in our next video. So please subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss out on that video.
From now on, I'll try and maintain a consistent schedule of uploading one video every 2 weeks. You can find the written version of this tutorial on codometry.in. I'll put a link for the same in the description. Like and share this video if you found it useful. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.